Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for our second bout of the evening. This School of Hard Knocks fight is an amateur bout in the 135-pound weight class and is brought to you by the YMCA School of Hard Knocks 17 official gym. And now, let's meet the fighters. He's fighting out of Invermere, British Columbia. He is Douglas Monfils-Smith.
Douglas Monfils-Smith coming down. Should be a familiar face to Hard Knocks fans in Medicine Hat. He fought the last time we were here in Medicine Hat. He fought again in Regina about a month ago. And I can tell you the difference in the two performances was incredible for this fighter.
Yeah, you know, his first fight, he kind of got owned. And his second fight, he came back a completely different fighter, landing powerful, powerful strikes, kept pressing the action, and he never gassed out. I hope we see that Douglas Monfils-Smith tonight. And if he's improved as much from his first fight to his second fight, from his second fight to his third fight, we're all going to be in for a real treat.
The former professional snowboarder making his way into the cage now and preparing to meet Andrew Shenfield.
And his opponent. He's fighting out of Edmonton, Alberta. He is Andrew Shenfield.
Now Andrew Shenfield comes into the Hard Knocks cage making his amateur debut, which he thinks is somewhat of an advantage that he has over Douglas Monfils-Smith because, of course, he was able to see Smith's fight from the Hard Knocks events in the past, and he knows what kind of fighter Monfils-Smith is and what kind of fights he's had so far, and he says that gives us somewhat of an advantage.
You know, Andrew fights and trains with the Red Dragons. They all live in a house together. They live, they breathe, they train mixed martial arts all the time. And with a coach like Jared Busmakers, who's so well-rounded on the ground, this guy is not going to come into this fight underprepared.
Out of Picks MMA in Edmonton, just 22 years old, is Andrew Shenfield as he gets set to step into the cage for this 135-pound battle. Says he got into the cage after watching Forrest Griffin and Stefan Bonner fight in the Ultimate Fighter Season 1, and I can tell you that that is a response I get really frequently when it comes to the amateurs. That series is probably responsible for half the guys on the Hard Knocks roster.
You know what? That first season of the Ultimate Fighter has really changed the sport. That opened everybody's eyes, not just to the fighting aspect, but to the personal aspect. That we're not all just fighters, we're people too. And behind the rugged exterior, you know, we're all just normal people getting into the cage, scrapping it out, making a paycheck.
And now for the official fighter introductions. In the onside restoration blue corner, he's 1-1 as an amateur and is 28 years old. He stands 5'6" tall and weighing in at 134.4 pounds. Fighting out of Martial X Mind, Body, and Spirit Fight Training in Invermere, please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Douglas Monfils-Smith! And in the Rouse, Texas Bar and Steakhouse Red Corner, it's his amateur debut. He's 22 years old and stands 5'8" tall. He weighed in at 135.2 pounds, fighting out of Pix Martial Arts in Edmonton. Please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Andrew Shenfield. This bout will be contested under amateur rules. The referee in charge of the Hard Knocks action is Mr. Mark Aparicio.
Gentlemen, get over the rules in the dressing room. I want you to fight fair, fight hard, obey my command at all times. If you want to touch gloves, do it now.
So we get set for our second fight of the night. Douglas Monfi Smith taking on Andrew Shenfield. Smith in the green trunks, Shenfield in the black trunks. And we are underway. They get set to meet at the center of the cage. Touch gloves, and we're ready to go. Shenfield comes out swinging, and he's already got a guillotine attempt on. We'll see if Monfi Smith can get out of this. Smith throwing punches up against the side of the cage, trying to pull his head free, and he does. A heck of an opening flurry from Andrew Shenfield.
Monfi Smith is not as well-rounded on the ground as he is standing, so he's going to need to be very careful here. And you got to think his opponent knows that, and that's why he went for the early submission attempt while he was still fresh.
He did win his last fight by verbal strikes or verbal tap out due to strikes on the ground. Monfi Smith was in this exact position a month ago when he started raining down punches, so it'll be very important for Shenfield to maintain wrist control here.
Shenfield's doing a very good job holding onto the wrist and causing Monfi Smith to create only minimal damage at this point.
Monfi Smith looking to try and pass, thus far unsuccessful. And now a little more into the guard, although now a pass attempt is successful into the full mount. Shenfield holding down Monfi Smith's head, trying to keep him from being able to posture up here.
You know, Monfi Smith really needs to get control of his position. He's got to hook in those back legs, make sure he's got the mount secure before he starts firing punches, or he's going to get swept easily here.
This is really going to test the escapability of Andrew Shenfield, and so far so good as he's able to get back to his feet and now has Monfi Smith up against the cage and secures a takedown of his own.
And this is a bad spot for Monfi Smith, especially when you're trained by a guy like Jared Busmakers, where his main area is jiu-jitsu. This is a very bad spot for Monfi Smith now.
Shenfield on top, trying to posture up, landed a couple shots inside, but so far unable to do much damage down there, and may find himself in an arm bar, but no, as Shenfield does punch his way out of it and backs up and allows Monfi Smith to stand up. Smith circles around now, breathing a little heavy is Smith. Shenfield looks ready to go, tries the crane kick a la Lyoto Machida versus Randy Couture, but no success, didn't land. And Shenfield came in with a couple of punches for his trouble and has landed a couple more, but Monfi Smith game to take them as he continues coming forward and proves that he's got a chin on him.
If you're going to throw a strike like that kick, you need to set it up with something, or your opponent's just going to need to take one step back and it's going to be worthless.
Both fighters swinging wildly, big gasping breath there out of Monfi Smith as we get towards the end of the first round. Threw a bit of a wild leg kick, connected but not very much. A big kick coming back the other way from Shenfield, though, who has landed the far more effective strikes here with just 10 seconds left in round number one.
Yeah, Monfi Smith is looking extremely tired at this point, but if you recall from his last fight, he looked tired the entire time but kept the pace up.
So both fighters put in a solid first round. Shenfield looks disappointed in himself as he walks towards his corner. Monfi Smith ready for the coaches to come in and talk it over with him. But not a bad first round from the amateur. Came out with a flurry. And Jordan, they tell me that that's something you have to watch out for when a guy's making his debut. If you're fighting a guy with experience, the debut guy's going to come out and try and finish that fight in the first 30 seconds so that he doesn't have to fight longer, doesn't have to test his cardio, doesn't have to get into the endurance rounds.
You know, and I mean, that mentality is what's got me through a lot of fights as well. You know, sometimes when you're nervous and you step in there, you like to throw those big bombs, try to get out of there a little early before things get a little too crazy.
ComTV.ca video coverage of this event is made possible in part by contributions from the following ComTV.ca sponsors. Ralph's Texas Bar and Steakhouse. Live music, huge dance floor, even a mechanical bull. Only at Ralph's. Life's too short to go anywhere else. Essential Coil and Stimulation Services. When safety is essential. D&D Oil Field. For all your oil field rentals.
So both these fighters getting a chat from their coaches. The whistle coming in from the timekeeper to let the coaches know that it's time to vacate. Again, 90 seconds between rounds here for the amateurs. Later on tonight, we will see just those 60-second stoppages for the pro fighters. Cage doors are closed. The referee just double-checking that before we get started here with round number two as Douglas Monfils-Smith comes out to face Andrew Shenfield at the center of the cage. Smith in the green trunks, Shenfield in the black trunks. Again, a good flurry start there from Shenfield. A big leg kick, though, coming from Smith. And Smith is rocked by a big punch from Shenfield there, as he seems to be recovering, but a big punch had him going half down, and he's eating a couple more here. Douglas Monfils-Smith is in trouble, and a desperation takedown attempt leads to a big knee to the belly and a guillotine attempt from Andrew Shenfield here. You don't see standing guillotines too often in MMA, but we've seen a couple attempts here in our first couple fights.
You know, Monfils-Smith does an incredible job of taking a punch and bouncing back from it. But, you know, if Andrew Shenfield just presses forward and doesn't get into the clinch position, just keeps his range and starts throwing those punches, he's going to land the finisher soon.
Blood coming from the nose now of Monfils-Smith as Shenfield has continued to land direct strikes. Monfils-Smith swinging with everything he's got, not connecting on much right now, as Shenfield doing a clinical job of taking apart Monfils-Smith on his feet.
Yeah, Shenfield's starting to pick Monfils-Smith apart now. Monfils-Smith is going to need to tighten up his stance, or it's just going to continue.
And a low blow there will send them to neutral corners as Douglas Monfils-Smith lands a bit of a low one on Shenfield. Shenfield letting the referee know. Now, he's got 5 minutes here if he should take it to recover from the low blow. However, at the same time, he knows his opponent has 5 minutes to recover from the stand-up, so coming out quickly is Andrew Shenfield. More punches landing from Shenfield, big punches, blood firing from Monfils-Smith, who takes this fight to the ground in an effort to get out of this round.
Very exciting fight put on by these two guys, you know, where it's not always the most technical. Sometimes these big bombs are what everybody comes to watch.
Hammer fist landing and landing hard from Smith on top of Shenfield, and he may now have the opportunity to get Shenfield's back. Shenfield holding onto the knee and sweeps him over, and now is on top of Smith.
If Monfils-Smith is a little bit more persistent here, he can pull that arm out and go for the armbar, but I think he just lost it.
Monfils-Smith back up onto the top, dropping elbows into the back of Shenfield. Those cannot feel good at all, as Shenfield taking a little bit of punishment here towards the end of round two.
Very durable Monfils-Smith, you know, that's what's hung him around here. And now if his opponent starts to gas out and get a little bit sloppier, this is where Monfils can start to win the fight.
Shenfield trying to push through, has a grasp of that single leg. Monfils-Smith not doing much on top from here. Although he now tries to work into a mount, tries to free one hand. Just 10 seconds left here in round number two. Blood covering the face of Monfils-Smith. And that's all coming from his nose. Tries to drop the armbar, but does not secure it in time. And that's the end of round two, as Douglas Monfils-Smith will need a towel to clean his face and arms and chest and every part of his upper body off, as he is bleeding quite badly from his nose. Shenfield, on the other hand, does look like he's okay in his corner. Nice, calm, cool, collected. It'll be interesting now where we get to the third and decided final round. You have to think at this point that Monfils-Smith is going to have to come out and finish this fight if he's going to win it, because it does look like Shenfield's got the better of him in the first two rounds, in that round especially, despite the time that Monfils-Smith spent on the top. I'd have to say an overwhelming advantage for Shenfield in the stand-up game, enough to surely secure him the round.
You know, I've said it enough times today, though, Monfils-Smith is extremely durable. So if he comes out swinging this round, you know, maybe he'll be able to take that punch that's not going to drop him to the ground. And he might get the upper hand on his definitely a more tired Andrew Shenfield this round.
Well, and you've also got to think about the psychological aspect too, Jordan, of Shenfield giving this guy absolutely everything he's had over the previous 6 minutes, and he's still coming forward, he's still coming at you, and he did end the round with an armbar attempt. Monfils-Smith now in danger of a guillotine again, right up in front of here right up in front of us here at the cage. Shenfield trying the guillotine, letting it go now. Monfils Smith trying for the takedown, clearly knowing that he's got the better of Shenfield on the ground so far, but knowing also nice judo throw there, but ends up on the bottom. Does Monfils Smith a full mount position here for Shenfield? Monfils Smith is hanging on, not allowing Shenfield to pop up and posture up, but you know that that's the eventual goal, is Shenfield's going to try and drop bombs from the top.
You know, it's got to be frustrating for Shenfield. You know, he's given Monfils Smith everything he has, and Monfils Smith just keeps on escaping and keep pushing. You know, when you've given somebody everything you have when you're fresh in the fight and you start to gas out in the later rounds, it's very discouraging. It's very hard to push forward because you don't have what you had in the first couple rounds.
Shenfield flattens Smith out, and this fight nearing over as the guillotine choke is in, and that is it. This fight is over. Monfils Smith eventually gives up the ghost with a rear naked choke victory for Andrew Shenfield in his amateur debut. Very happy coaches carrying him around the cage, and a little fist pump there for Monfils Smith on the way by. A nice performance from the amateur in his first debut.
The official decision, a special thank you goes out to YMCA for providing our fighters a gym to train and cut weight.
ComTV.ca video coverage of this event is made possible in part by contributions from the following ComTV.ca sponsors: Ralph's Texas Bar and Steakhouse, live music, huge dance floor, even a mechanical bull, only at Ralph's. Life's too short to go anywhere else. Essential Coil and Stimulation Services, when safety is essential. D&D Oil Field, for all your oil field rentals.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the official decision brought to you by the YMCA. The winner by tap out due to rear naked choke at 1:09 in the third round, in the red corner, Andrew Shenfield!
Congratulations on winning your amateur debut. I just heard you say to your opponent there, you caught me good a couple times. A battle start to finish here.
Yeah, he caught me with the right on the bridge of the nose, and I was really surprised. I watched a video on him before, and yeah, he came with a lot of new moves to the table today.
Now, you had an initial flurry. You come out, you touch gloves in round number one, you throw a couple punches, you try for the guillotine choke. Was that part of the strategy to end this fight as quickly as possible?
No, I seen I had the opportunity to go for it, and I went for it, and unfortunately, I didn't get it, so just kept on going.
Now, when the fight went to the ground, a lot of good work from your jiu-jitsu. You end the fight with a rear naked choke. I'm sure you have coaches to thank for that.
Yeah, I do. My cornerman, Jared, and my other cornerman, B-Tang. I mean, those guys are the reason why I'm here right now. So I have to give a good thanks to them and my teammates back at PIX Mixed Martial Arts and the Red Dragons team. So thanks, guys.
One more time for your winner, Andrew Shenfield.
This is Ayaz with MMA News Canada. I'm here with Andrew Shenfield from PIX Martial Arts. Just won a fight here in Medicine Hat. How do you feel?
Feeling pretty good. It was first time, got the jitters out of the way, and I'm ready to go again.
Yeah, that was great. It looked like he hit you hard a couple of times. Like, how did it feel through the fight?
I was actually surprised with the stand-up. I watched a video on him, and all he had was the right hand, and he actually caught me more with the left, and he got me pretty good. My nose is swollen, black eye, and I don't know, it was a little bit different than what I expected, but I got the win, so I'm pretty happy.
Perfect. Did you feel like that choke was tight? Like, it kind of, you had him standing up, choked?
The first one, I did have it. I just didn't have the proper angle on it, so yeah. He was able to get his head out, and unfortunately, I don't know, I thought I had it then, but I don't know, I was actually happy I went into the third round, so yeah, I got to test my cardio out, so I was pretty happy.
Do you feel like your cardio got you the win?
Not really, because this is my first time cutting weight, and I had a little bit of a difficult time doing it, so I felt a little gassed in the third, my arms were a little sluggish, but yeah, I was happy to get the choke. It was something that I really wasn't expecting. I thought I'd end it standing up, but yeah. I'll take it.
Yeah. Well, it was a great debut. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
Yeah, I'd like to thank my guys at Pixmix Martial Arts and Team Red Dragons, and I'm ready to go for another one.
Ready to go.
Nice. We look forward to seeing you again. Thanks
thank
a
you.
Lot. Okay, this is Ayaz with MMA News Canada. I'm here with Douglas Monfey with Martial X. Lost your fight today, but I mean, how do you feel it went? This is your third fight.
Oh, I don't know. Again, I felt slow and weak and couldn't transition, but hey, I let it go until the end. I tried to keep fighting, but it was either blackout or tap out, so.
It felt like maybe conditioning, like how did you feel your training camp went?
Oh, it's weak, that's what I need. But like I said, I work full time and I have two kids to look after, so really they're my training partners, and I gotta train while at work, keep it secret like Karate Kid style, so I guess this will, hopefully she lets me fight again and maybe I can get someone to help me out and do it. If I have time to train, then maybe I can take it more serious.
Perfect, yeah. I mean, it looked like you were throwing some pretty good haymakers. Sweet. When they were hitting, they were looked like it was hurting.
Nice.
Yeah. Well, we hope to see you back soon, man. Get trained up, and hopefully sooner than later.
Hopefully. Thanks a lot, man.
Not a problem. Talk to you later.